Welcome students to your second class of BRM Business Research Methods. In first class, we have defined BRM or research. Some concepts were there. Over there, we were saying that BRM or research is the systematic investigation to a problem, process or phenomena by the use of scientific methods. Research is a systematic investigation by the use of scientific method to find out solution for an existing problem, phenomena or situation is called research. Today our topic is about some basic research terminologies. It is our lecture number second. Lecture number second, basic research terminologies. In some classes, in every semester when we are starting the subject of BRM, we are taking some basic classes of these research terminologies. If you are not focusing on these basic terminologies, obviously you will not be knowing any concept in coming classes or in coming semester or in this semester when we are proceeding to next topics or advanced topics. So it's must, you must have learned all these topics what I am going to present in front of you people, basically research terminologies. Number one of which I have taken data, second is information, population, sample. In a sample I have taken two things, sample definition, then those two things are sample unit and sample size. Data, in first semester I have also explained a specific definition of this data or information. Today I have written it, all these things over here on this whiteboard so that you can learn it completely. So most of the students, they are using data and information interchangeably, but remember one thing, that data and information in research, they are not one thing. The word data, it is plural word, it has been taken from datum, d-a-t-u-m, datum, d-a-t-u-m, datum, it is data. So how, obviously data, we are requiring data in each and every step of research, or research is impossible without data. So what is data? Data is raw and unorganized facts or statistics that need to be processed. We are having some information, we are having some facts, but those facts are raw facts, unorganized facts. Those facts, that information or that calculation, or we can call it that raw statistics, that need to be processed. Actually in research, what we are doing, we are collecting data, different types of data, by different means, by different manners, by different methods, and we are processing that data because that is unorganized, to convert it into information. This overall process of converting data to information is called research. But what is data? I told you that it is raw facts, or raw form of information, or raw statistics, or unorganized facts, or unorganized statistics, that need to be organized, that need to be converted according to a required structure, then it will become information. So in data, for every research, we have got two types of data, primary data and secondary data. Obviously you have studied in previous semester what is primary data, what is secondary data. Primary data is also called first hand data. Primary data or first hand data that a researcher is collecting for the first time, that's why it is called primary data or first hand data. And nobody has worked on it or nobody has collected such type of data, it is called primary data or first hand data. For the first time you are collecting data for your research, that is called primary data. Then other type of, second type of data is called secondary data. From its name it is clear, secondary data. It is also called second hand data, or we can say desk data. Desk data that is already available at your desk, in your computer, in books, etc. That's why it is called desk data or secondary data or second hand data. So in data, we got two types of data, primary data and secondary data. Primary data is also called first-hand data. Secondary data is also called desk data. Primary data is the data which we are collecting for the first time. Secondary data is the data that is already available in book form, in information, website form, video form. But however, somebody has worked on it and collected the data for his own purpose or research. That is called secondary data. So that is called data. Now, what is meant by information? Information, when data is organized, structured or presented in a given context to make it useful. Obviously, the data has become the information, but how it has become the information? We processed it through a proper sequence of steps, some 4 or 5 steps to convert this data into information. Actually, information is also a data, but that is not general data, that is not raw data, but instead it is organized data or structured data. That structured data means that this data is presented in a given context, in a given structure, in a given framework, in a given framework, and it has become useful. It has become useful. How it has become useful? It has become useful because it has provided us the complete answer for the question that is related to our problem, the problem for which we are conducting a research. We collected the data, we processed it, we make it information, and that information is useful, or it is the overall answer of the problem that was existing before the research. So that is called information. We are conducting the research to convert this raw or unorganized facts or statistics to information, or organized or structured data, which is called information. So this is the difference between data and information. It's very much important thing. Most often students are making their mistakes, or most commonly in general society, in general English or in general language, we are using data and information interchangeably, one instead of other. But in research, there are two different things. The whole research is required for converting the data to the information. That day in the first class, I have told you that we are using a specific method, which we are calling it scientific method. In scientific method, there were some 7-8 steps. When question was arising, then you are conducting an informal research. When we were conducting informal research, then we were making a statement according to our mind, according to our perception, that was called hypothesis. In hypothesis, we have got two types of hypothesis: null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Then we were testing the hypothesis, we were getting the conclusion, and we were making the report. So this overall process is required to convert the data into information, which we are calling over there scientific method. Or in simple words, we can say that in research we are using scientific method to convert this data into information. Probably now it's clear to you people. Then this portion, most of the time our students, even they are completing their research after 8 semesters, when they are coming to their research or thesis defense, they don't know these concepts. So you will have to learn this concept by hook or by crook. Population, I will clear all these things to you people with proper example, so that nothing should be ambiguous or nothing should be unclear to you. I need you to learn it very well. Population, it includes all the elements from the set. From the set means the people, the thing, the phenomena about whom we are going to conduct research, that is called set. I am giving you one example. Let's suppose we are conducting research about BBA students. That what are the financial problems of BBA students while they are studying at the university. BBA students. We are conducting our research about overall BBA students of a country, of Afghanistan. So this overall BBA students, maybe they are in lakhs, they are 2 lakhs, they are 3 lakhs, they are 1 million. That is called population. Or it includes all the elements, all the BBA students up from the set, BBA students from the set. The set means the overall BBA students of that country. elements, all the BBA students. So it includes all the elements from the BBA students is called population. Or we are conducting a research about the, let's put, businessmen. What are the challenges, security challenges faced by our businessmen? So all the businessmen of the whole country, business people, we are calling it population. Or for example, we are conducting a research by the, for about doctors, that how a doctor can become a professional doctor, or what are other problems faced by doctors while becoming specialist in a specific field. So look, we are conducting research by we are conducting research about doctors. So doctors, all doctors of a country, that is called our population. So now, obviously, most of the times when I'm explaining this thing, population, a question arises in the minds of the students. One of the students asks, sir, is it possible to conduct research or collect data from all BBA students of one country? I am saying no, it's not possible, or even if it is possible, it will be very expensive or time consuming or not possible for students or for researchers to cover all BBA students in the whole country within a limited period of time with a limited budget, etc. So for this purpose, what we are doing in the research, we are making our process simple for collection the data from the overall population. For this purpose, another concept comes, sample. Sample means namuna. Okay, sample, a sample consists of a specific number of observation from the population. Means we are taking a limited number from this population. We were conducting research about BBA students. BBA students, I told you before that they may be in millions. That may be in millions, or that may be in lakhs in the whole country. It's impossible for us to collect data from all BBA students, from 1 million BBA students, to make our job easier. What we are doing? We are selecting a specific number of BBA students. Let's suppose we are taking some 500 BBA students. Some 500 BBA students we are selecting from the whole country to represent the overall population, to represent the BBA students of the whole country. So those people whom we are selecting for our research, a limited number of observation, we are calling it sample. Let's suppose we are selecting some 4 or 5 universities from different cities. So those universities or those students whom we are selecting for our research to represent the overall population of BBA students of the whole country, that is called sample. That's why I have written over here that what is the definition of the sample. You can write any type of definition over here in the social science. You know, in first semester I have told you, if you remember, that science, we are dividing science into two branches, social science, natural science. Natural science, biology, physics, chemistry, etc., in which we cannot make our own definition. Like we cannot change the atomic number or atomic mass or chemical formula of a thing, of a substance, or other names, species, etc. So we cannot change, we cannot make our own definition over there in that field. But in social sciences which is about societies, human, like BBA, sociology, psychology, BCS, languages, all these subjects, all those fields are called social science. See, in social science, based on the concept, you can make your own definition. So sample represents the overall population. Okay, our population is represented by sample. Now going a little bit forward, in sample we have got two concepts over here related to the sample. One is called sample unit, other is called sample size. Sample unit, we were conducting research about BBA students. Let's suppose Hassan, Asad is our BBA student. Or Mustafa is our BBA students. So we are also collecting data from Mustafa. Now Mustafa is one of the person of our sample. So Mustafa is called sample unit. Or Bilal is called sample unit. Or Asad is called sample unit. So every individual, every member of that sample is called sample unit. Every individual of the sample is called sample unit. From whom we are collecting our data to represent the overall population. That is called sample unit. In your research defense, these questions are often asked. But unfortunately, most of the students are giving answers wrongly. Then we have got sample size. Again, the same question. From BBA students, we are collecting the data. BBA students of 3-4 universities. Let's suppose 500 students we have selected from different universities to represent the overall 5 lakh BBA students. So these 500, how many students we have selected from universities? 500. Unfortunately, I don't have students in front of me to say 500. 500 students will represent the overall population. Those 500 students, which we have called the number of the respondents, is called sample size. Those 500 BBA students is called sample size. The number of respondents is called sample size. Or somebody is asking you that what is your sample size, you should answer that my sample size is 500. So students, today these were basic research terminologies, or we can say that it is the language of research. If you don't know this language of research, probably it will be very much difficult for you people to proceed forward. So it is requested that please listen to my words very carefully and learn each and everything. Still, if you are having any question, ask me through social media. Thank you very much, students. We'll see you in the next class. Khuda Hafiz.